Hi everyone, in this video, we are going through the option pricing by using our program.
How to price options? Well, options are priced depending on 6 parameters, as follows.
The current price of the underlying asset, S. The strike price, K. The underlying asset's volatility, sigma. The risk-free rate, R. The dividend rate, Q. The formula here, there is already subtract with the risk-free rate, so it shows only R here, and the time to maturity with units in years, T. The function N that appears in the formula denotes the cumulative function of the standard normal distribution. However, there are assumptions behind the model. Obviously, these assumptions are not met in the reality. But the Black-Scholes model offers the best way to price options for now. Now, let's price an option by using the Black-Scholes model in R. Before we start, just so you know, we'll be focusing on the option pricing functions only. For the other purposes, you can take a look online. First, we open RStudio program. There are actually 4 main parts. Top left is for writing commands. Bottom left is result of summoning the codes that you wrote. Top right shows the environment and bottom right shows the plots. You can type your code as a function here. I'll give you an example of a general option model that we're all familiar with, Black-Scholes Merton, which the model is closed form formula to price an option. Let's say I would like to compute a call option price given 6 variables, spot price S, strike price K, annual risk-free rate R, volatility sigma, dividend yield delta, time at maturity double capital T, and time at evaluation double small t. First, we need to state 6 inputs in a function of BSM call. Then, open the blanket to input D1 and D2 formulas.
After we state that D1 and D2 are normal distributed function, then state call option pricing formula. I name it as call value.
Call value is equal to S spot multiplied by exponential minus delta multiplied by double capital T minus double small t multiplied by normal distribution D1, which the formula is above, minus k multiplied by exponential of minus r multiplied by in the blanket of double capital T minus double small t multiplied by p norm D2, which is the formula above. Close the blanket. After we finish filling formula, we then compare by giving 6 inputs. Call 1, BSM call, in the blanket, spot is 96, strike price is 90, and a risk-free rate, let's say 10%, sigma 0.25, delta 0, double capital T 1, and double small t 0.25. Let's run it. Oops, there is an error. It says unexpected close blanket here. So we can go back and check and delete our error. Okay, after we fix the mistake, run it again. The result is the call option price based on 6 input variables is 15.5. As you may know, there are different variety of options out there in the market, depending on benefits and cost of risks. We can generally categorize into standard option. Let's share 3 types of exotic options to get you familiar for your future studies: Asian option, binary option, and lookback option. Okay, let's get started with Asian option. The reason I pick Asian option is because this is a basic form of exotic options. Its payoff is pretty much similar to standard options. The difference is that payout is determined by the average value of underlying asset over predetermined period, whereas payoff of the standard options depend on the price of underlying at the specific point in time. Therefore, it is also known as average value option. Basically, these options allow you to buy or sell the underlying at the average price instead of spot price. After we have done manually priced a call option using Black-Scholes model, I prepare the package of codes that contain three main pricing commands for each exotic option. But first, you need to download the file fexoticoption. Then, we need to install the file from our library using the command. After we install the file, Asian options formula in R is called geometric average rate option. If you have no idea what geometric average rate option is, you can simply fill question mark sign in the front, then highlight it and run the code. The bottom right pop-up information of geometric average rate option free you. Easy busy, right? Are you following us? I hope yes. Now, let's tell R the value of your six variables. I apply the previous example from Black-Scholes model, which spot price is 96, strike price 90. Time computed from 1 minus 0.25, which is 0.75, R 0.1, delta B 0.1, sigma 0.25. Note that type flag C means that I would like to price call option. Are you ready? Check your codes, then run. Here you go. Price 1 is the call option price. You can click it for more detail to see input parameters and the value of this call option, which is 9.96. But if you want the price to immediately pop up on the screen, you just add one more command in the back, add price. Then, why we use this option? Due to its features, its volatility is less than the volatility of the spot price, which make Asian options are less expensive than the standard counterparts. It can also reduce the market manipulation, which is another main benefit. On the other side, note that Asian option will not provide the opportunity to make large profit at peak moments, which is created by high volatility. Wake up, guys! We are moving on to the second exotic option, binary option. As you may aware of the name binary, this option simply depends on either of the two outcomes, which is a yes or no proposition. You get the payoff if option expires in the money and incur a loss if it expires out of the money. The main features of binary option are it sets a fixed maximum payout and it limits the risk only for the amount that you invested. So, you don't have to bother with the movement of the underlying asset. No matter which type of binary option you trade, the risk is the position size on a single trade. Binary option pricing for R is pretty much similar to Asian option. I brought you two examples. One is asset or nothing option. Another is cash or nothing option. Inputs of asset or nothing option are similar to Asian and European options. So, here's the example for you. Type tag P for put S 70, strike price X 65, time 0.5 for half year, R 0.07, B 0.02, and sigma 0.27. But for cash or nothing option, one additional variable is required, which K is the cash at the expiration if the binary option is in the money. The command is cash or nothing option. Type flag as the same as asset or nothing option. Spot price 100, X 80, K 10. Time 9 over 12, you can type this. R 0.06, B 0, and sigma 0.35. There you go. The prices for two options pop up. I will leave binary barrier options for you to try. Here we come to the last exotic option for this video, the look-back options. Again, for more detail, you can search online. To price the look-back option, we calculate the option's price at or near the widest expected distance of price differential based on the past volatility and demand for the options. There are two broadly types of look-back options. First, the floating strike look-back option. We calculate the payoff by comparing the close price and the most favorable strike price. So the input variables of floating strike look-back option are similar to Asian. For the lowest price observed of the underlying in the case of the call, or the highest price in the case of the put, as min or max command, instead of strike price. You can simply compute the price in R. For example, you want to price a call option with the current asset price at $120. The asset used to have the lowest price at $100. The contract will be expired in 6 months. Risk-free rate is 1%, 5% for cost of carry, and 30% for volatility. Then, bang! The price of these options would be $27 as shown here. Second, fixed strike look-back option. We fix the strike price as always, but the holder can pick the best underlying asset price to compute the payoff. Pricing this option are the same as the floating strike look-back option, but we need one more factor, which is the fixed strike price. Let's assume that the fixed strike price is $110. We type the formula, add the same variables as previous, and add the strike price here. Then run the result. So the price for the fixed strike look-back option would be around $35. Here we come to the end of this video. We do appreciate to make this video and thank you all, everyone, for watching. You can find our coding package under this video. Thank you so much.